What's going on, guys? It's Tyre here, back again with another video for you guys. Today I got the new Overwatch map gameplay for you guys. It's called Lunar Horizon Colony or whatever. And basically I'm gonna give my thoughts on the map. Basically what I think of this new map. It's kind of different. It's so much different than like any other map. It has like a lot more like kind of vertical gameplay, and also like seems like there's a lot more longer sight lines. There is the classic, just choke points and that, but like I feel like in between choke points, it's like a lot more.
This life's never
uneventful. Overall, I'd say pretty decent map. It's hard to tell, right? I haven't played on it that much, so I can't give my real in-depth opinion on it, but, I don't mind it. Different. simply put, I do want to try playing, I feel like Widowmaker would honestly be, really good on this map. Just because of all the bigger open lanes, I think Widowmaker would actually be really good. I was using kind of a more lineage character. I was using the new McCree. A few videos ago, three, 4 videos ago, I was talking about some changes that are on the PTR, and all those changes went live with the latest update, when this map came, and they also did some reworks, they did all those reworks I talked about in my other video. Basically, now McCree, his ultimate, got a buff, basically. Lock-ons that, happens, with characters, that, starts sooner, you'll lock-on faster, I guess, and then also within the first second of first 2 seconds or something like that of when his lock-ons you'll deal more damage. So the idea with it is that now you can quickly pop his ultimate and then just get a triple killer swing. So I was trying to use that in this gameplay, but I think I was actually trying to shoot way too fast. I end up whiffing a lot, but I think he's definitely going in a really good direction. I don't necessarily know about the current meta. He'll be necessarily I think he will be more viable. Only in certain situations, but some of the other changes that went live was Reaper. I only got to play one game with him, but kind of have an opinion on it in case you don't know what they did with him. He doesn't drop his what are they called, soul orbs. He doesn't drop those anymore. Instead he gets he gets health back. I can't remember the percentage. I want to say 10% of his damage output, he gets it back in health or something. I can't remember the exact numbers. I'd have to look it up. But it's basically battling someone and then he's kind of healing himself just like with no damage. I kind of feel like it's gonna make him kind of weaker and just but it's gonna make his ultimate a lot better. Think about it like that. I don't think he's gonna be able to get killed as easily in the ultimate anymore. Like, it's because he's gonna be constantly up damage and during the raid. And as long as that's connected to the ability, he's gonna be getting health back. Like, I don't know, I think his ultimate is gonna be crazy now. Like, I wanna get a chance to get a good game in with him. Well, I actually used to play Reaper a little bit, so. I was pretty decent with him, but
I've got you in my sights.
Yeah, what else changed? Roadhog had a bunch of rework. I haven't ever been a fan of Roadhog, so I don't plan on testing out those changes. But like, apparently he's just like dead now. Like, so like, he kind of got nerfs and buffs, but like. Nerfed so much, it's just kind of killed him. I don't have much time, I'll kind of quickly explain. Basically, his fire rate got increased, but his damage got decreased. So, he also got one more clip, one more shot in his clip, but basically, he's kind of dead now, even though he can shoot faster, but he can't one-shot as many characters now, like with his combo. So therefore, he's kind of dead. But anyways, this gameplay is going to be. I will be having more videos. I have a few kind of videos saved up, so
without
further ado, leave like, comment, subscribe. And so until next time, guys, we'll see you guys later.